Hello Tubesters, it's Gav and welcome to another one of my videos. Today we are all at sea, so make sure you've got those seasick tablets because we have got the very first instalment of my Type 23 Frigate HMS Kent from Trumpeter, and the scale is 1350. Don't expect too much from the build so far. I can't say fit-wise, if it's good or bad, well, I suppose I could really, you know, because I have glued some bits together. I suppose you can say good, as far as I know, first ship that I've made since I was about 15. You know, it's gone together fine. There was, on the sonar bulge at the front, I'm not that nautical, I love my ships, but I don't know enough to start talking naval terminologies. The sonar buoy bulge at the front, that had a fairly decent gap, and because it's, well, I'll show you in a minute where it is, at the front, funny enough, the pointy end, the bow. I used CA glue, super glue, to fill it with some talcum powder in, and it was really still quite, there was a quite step because I put some primer on to see, although I could really see that I knew it wasn't gonna just be straightforward. So I've gone down it again. I've put some Mr. Hobby 500 filler on, you know, the really thick stuff. I just brush painted that on just to see if, you know, and then I gently sanded it again to see if I could get it to conform a bit better. I believe it's as good as I'm going to get it. Just going to have to live with what I've got at the moment. I am looking for a canning effect on the hull, so I suppose in real life it might not be that far removed from what it looks like. As I say, I've just got the hull and the deck on at the moment, and a few small fittings which I tend to knock off as quick as I stick them on. So let's go down at the bench and we should take a look. Okay, Tubesters, we've reached a small dilemma here. I didn't realise that a 1 in 350 scale ship, even a smaller one like this frigate, I couldn't actually get into the view of the camera. Lesson to self, use the big tripod next time, but I don't intend getting it out of the cupboard and setting it all up now. We've already gone down that road. So this is what I've done. Sorry about this. I shall bring up parts of it to the camera. Just let me get my glasses on because I won't be able to see a thing without them. Oh, that's better. Right. So this is the quarter deck, I believe. You add on this bulkhead here, and that comes with a watertight door already on. I have got a photo etch from Atlantic Models, which I will show you the sheet in a bit. Because I haven't cut anything off yet. It has a few doors on, but not enough that you could do the entire ship with. You add on that bollard there as well for bollard. I'm not sure anyway, but for hauling in the ropes. Normally, there's a on the more mod the up to date versions. This is she launched in 2000, and I believe this rear area is correct for that period. Some of them I see have I have no idea what it's called, sticking out just below the waterline, sticking out the back, and I believe it's to stop the foam comb coming out the back so bad. I can't remember what it's called. There's also, I don't know if I've got it in the etch here, because I'm not even sure if Trumpeter supply, because they have a small etch fret as well. But there's some netting at the back to either stop crew members falling out the back, or I suppose even when import terrorists even getting up through the back there. She normally has they tow an array out the back. Now, on a lot of the older photographs I've seen, I've not seen one at all. So whether she even these frigates did that in the early days, I'm not too sure. But the problem is you can't even get any books on the subject. I know there's obviously secrets and stuff, but they don't seem very popular. I don't mean just Type 23s, but modern warships. There's loads of books on, you know, HMS Hood and other warships, but not on more modern ones. And I couldn't find anything on the Type 23 at all. So I'm having to glean everything offline, and I forget it as quick as I want to tell you it. So yeah, you add on these side bulkheads as well here and here. I drilled out the two holes here. They are for the hawsers. I don't know if, I believe it's just when she's in port or she can, I suppose, tie up to boys out there as well. But I've seen them tied up in port through there, putting lines through there. So I drilled that out rather than just put a bit of black paint in there. I used that Russian brown black, which has got a lot of brown in it. So I thought it was quite shady. I put a grey primer down just to see where the humps and bumps were, and I think that's quite worked quite well, because in these ships, whenever you look at them on walkarounds, when people have taken photographs from the quayside or whatever you call it, the side, it's all dark in there. Obviously, there's a deck that's coming over at the top of this. I have cut it out, but I've got to remove a plastic like vented area and put a PE piece in, so I've got to dig that out yet with my chisel, chase it out. But that fits on top of there. I have left the props out and the prop shaft and all that because I wasn't sure, like on bits on an aircraft, or even a tank, like putting a 50 cal on halfway through the build, so you're always going to be knocking it off. So for now, I've left them off, and I'm not sure whether to leave them off until this is all painted or stick them on, because I'm going to be painting this fairly soon, I think. Because I stuck these I did have the words from in my head, but they're fins for stability, I believe. This is the bulbous bit at the front, which I believe's got sonar in. Sorry, the light's bouncing off it. You can still see a bit of a line, but I'm hoping that when I put my paint on, that goes away. I've added these little tie-off bollards at the front. I've added the bow anchor, I suppose, the other anchor on the side. There isn't one on this side. Breakwater combing thing here, I've put that on. A couple of little winches as well, again for bringing in cables, the anchor cable. Remove the anchor cable, but left, I wanted to leave it very slightly so I knew where it was properly, because I've got some photo etch to put on that. A lot of people use the chain, you can buy chain, and I did think about it, and I looked at it, and it was like, I think it was about £6 or £8, something like that, and I just thought, I ain't got a load of money at the moment, and this is my first ship. Let's go with a photo etch, because I've bought that, and yes, it's flat, but let's go with a photo etch for now, and let's see how good it looks when it's done. And if not, the next ship I do, I'll get some chain for. Obviously, you can see bits and pieces still got to be done there. So you've got your gun there. This is for the SeaCat launcher. It's now Sea Scepter, and all they've done is put a new missile system in the same space. I believe that the launch doors, which are like little round doors, I believe they may be slightly different shape, because they've gone from SeaCat, where they could launch just one missile out of a tube, to I'm not sure if it's two missiles or four missiles they can launch out of a single tube. It's called Sea Scepter. These are the launch tubes for the Sea Wolf, or where you'll be building up your launch tubes. This is obviously the bridge area. I put these winches on, seem quite early on in the build to do that, but they've got me to put those on. Funnel, and again, I don't know enough funnel structure to go on there, and the aircraft, but helicopter hangar at the back. Now, the one problem I've been having was, and for the life of me, why I didn't use me wax pencil before, I've no idea. Again, Gav's mind has been trained to use wax pencil on photo etch and not think of picking up little bits of plastic with it, but I had to add all these little bollards here that they put the ropes through, the little rounded ones. Now, I've made mine, that one I managed to make round afterwards, but these two are fairly square. But anyway, as usual, ping, 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 out the tweezers, over the shoulder. And now I'm on laminate floor, and I can normally find most of what lands on the floor, but do you think I could find those? So I made these out of lead wire, because that was the thinnest type of wire I'd got that I could bend quite easy. Now at the moment they just look like rungs on a tank or something like that. So I thought to try and make them look more rounded. When I looked at the pictures, they are more rounded. I'm going to try and put a little fillet of photo etching if I can. Because what I've been doing as well is knocking these blasted things off and then having to remake them. I'm really sorry for not. I'd never thought that it wouldn't actually fit in the viewfinder. So what I'm actually going to do is, next time we do one of these, I'll have a lot more to show you, and I'll put the my big tripod up, which has got the overhead look, and then we'll be fine on that. So just bear with me a moment and we'll get some photo etch out. Right guys, these are the this is the photo etch from Trumpeter. So you do get some, and they're good enough to put all the different radar antenna, all the really thin stuff. So that's good. You get a few ladders, which I believe will go up to the radar antenna. A couple of small gratings. I'm not sure, to be honest with you, what any of it really does yet until I get to that stage. It seems okay. I'm a fairly novice at all this, so I'm not sure. I'm not prepared to say how good the photo etch is, soft, hard, whatever, you know. But it's there. The one thing I don't understand, and I've heard other modellers say it with ships, is, you know, I can understand not putting watertight doors on and all that stuff. If you know, as in including it in brass. It's good that they've done this, because it's never going to look the same in thick plastic. They wouldn't get the scale right. But I don't understand why they don't give you ship's railings. I mean, they're a massively integral part to a ship of any era, you know. And I don't get why, if you're going to provide photo etch like this, for the cost of ship's railings, it's beyond me why they don't put it in. But anyway, they don't. So that's what you do get with the kit. Now this is from Atlantic Models, and it is obviously their Type 23. I haven't put any IPA or over this yet. I'm actually thinking of spraying the entire sheet with Halfords primer. Peter, who's company this is and who does all this, he suggests Halfords primer. I just happen to have the metal primer anyway, obviously for the soldiers, when I'm not using the airbrush. But it's fairly comprehensive. Well, it is comprehensive. Here's our anchor chain. These are ladders, which obviously you can cut up to, and there's a lot of ladders that go to different areas of the ship. You can obviously have these doors open or shut, and they just add, although they're the only doors that are on this, so there's no way could they cover the entire ship, but they do give you the option then to have doors open if you fancy that, you know, I suppose, to add some difference. What else have we got? No idea. Oh, you do get a really comprehensive instruction sheet with this, by the way. I'm just trying to do this off the cuff, and I have no idea what half of it is. We've got, obviously, again, it's replicated, I believe, the fit for the radar and everything. So, you know, you take your pick between this and the Trumpeter one. These little guys down here are actually mini guns, or the general purpose machine gun. I think, from... I've read somewhere, not on anything official, it was on somebody building one, that you could, or it could even be in Peter's sheet, that you could, I have seen them mounted either to the rear of the aircraft hangar, mainly for when they're in port and, or going through something like the Persian Gulf, you know, where there's a good chance that they can be attacked by swarm boats, you know, trying to blow themselves up. They can either be by the aircraft hangar or up on the bow of the right on the bow of the ship. And they've got like little ballistic screens that they can put up around the gunner. But I wouldn't be surprised if they don't put them on board, you know, in any numbers for a particular situation. You've got rotor blades for the helicopters, either big one for the Merlin, the small one for the, I've called it the Lynx, but I think that might change now. Or you can have them folded up. Other pieces. and the all-important ship's railings, which is there is a full set of. You just know I'm going to stuff these up, but and they're angled to the deck as well, which is really great. So I thoroughly recommend, you know, again, I'll always shout out a business that I think has given really decent service, and that is Atlantic Models here. I think they're a UK company. Right, sorry for the interruption, guys. That was the postman delivering my IPMS membership card. So Gav will go to the ball, COVID permitting, and any other thing that will forestall that. So yeah, guys, I've even lost my train of thought now. So yeah, we've got some anchor chain. It's not perfect. Obviously, it's flat. It's photo etched. So I had a good look at the one that was on the ship itself, moulded on. It didn't seem particularly in scale to me. It seemed really quite tiny. And I thought, well, you can actually see the links on this. So it's better than nothing. So, you get your little, because it's a Duke class. As I've said to you guys before, you'll see him, like said, as HMS Kent. Well, it's actually HMS Duke of Kent. And I don't understand why the Navy don't give them the full title of the ship, because it's not named after the County of Kent, it's named after the Duke of Kent. And all the, and there it is there, the Dukes, all Dukes have a crown. I know nothing, but it's a crown anyway, and all the ships, I believe, have the crown on their funnel. And then they have the emblem of that Duke, you know, like the Duke of Kent is a red shield with a white horse, because the white horse is the symbol of the County of Kent. So yeah, why they don't call it like St. Albans, you know, it's not named after St. Albans, it's named after the Duke of St. Albans, Duke of Richmond, the Iron Duke, which sounds slightly different because that was the name of the Duke of Wellington. But yeah, no idea, but I'm waffling now as always. Just wanted to say as well, I've got these. My wife often brings me back bits of packing filler from work. We were recycling long before it became trendy for modelling related projects and that. And I thought I could actually cut these into a V shape and have a sat. I mean, obviously she's got these planes on the side as well, but so I can actually use it to actually model on rather than keep handling. At the moment that's why I've not bothered painting or adding propellers on rudders or anything like that, because I knew I needed to do a fair bit of work on the bow there with a sonar buoy, and that proved to be the case, and that I was doing a bit of other filling where there's a slight gap near the bow. So yeah, I thought if I make myself a V-shape in that, and I can leave these separate because they sit on little, you know, flat bits, and I can move them up and down to the shape of a size of a ship type of thing, whatever I'm making. So yeah, you often hear me say that because I genuinely do. You know, I can bump my gums and get downhearted when things aren't going right, and I'll always put a video up like that because I've always said I like, you know, it's not all everything going great when I make a model. Obviously, like a lot of us, you know, we hit a wall sometimes, but I like, you know, I always say this, I love my ships, I love my tanks, I love my airplanes, because I just do, you know, I just enjoy it. I love my figures, obviously, but I always loved, I think I built about every ship that Airfix ever produced back in the day, until you got to the modern stuff. It was all, you know, Ajax, Graf Spee, I don't know if it was Cumberland, but, you know, all that type of era type ships. And I did all the Matchbox ones as well. I built a lot of their stuff. So it's great to be building another ship. again, they're not exactly small, but then again, you can get this, by the way, in the smaller scale, the 1:700, but I don't know, I like this scale because you've got something to work at. As I say, my ideas are, I wanted to pimp up the different superstructures, you know, just, they're actually pretty good. They've added a lot of the little boxes, and which I have no idea. And that's the other thing I was saying to Greg Riley the other day. I must have spent hours looking at this blooming thing that I've got to fit on the side here, actually, fairly soon on the deck. And I think it's actually a gangway, you know, put down for obviously going in and off ship. But in most of the cases, although this one isn't, I've seen it covered up, tarped up, you know, and roped up, you know, tarp round. Rope round a tarpaulin and covered up. And I also saw there's also two other little things that go on the side, and I have to call them little because I have no idea, you know, that you can't get like an anatomy of a ship book for this. You have to just, you know, look at photographs and try and work out yourself. You know, I was an infantry soldier, I wasn't a, you know, and I say the one and only time I ever stepped on board a Royal Navy warship was. As a soldier, was on a Type 23 for about 12 hours. So, yeah, you know, it's... but I do love them, you know. I think it's fantastic, you know. And I like modern... I can do World War II, Great War warships, but I do like the modern... I'm not 100% on the really up-to-date ones because, obviously, they're trying to make them as radar-proof as possible. And they all start looking, yeah, I know they are different, but they do look start looking samey, you know, whereas up to the mid-2000s, you could pick most countries' warships out for, you know, where they came from. They do a very nice Japanese destroyer, I think. They do some lovely American ones. They too are Type 45, which, you know, it's the usual thing. Airfix have done this and Trumpeter have done this wrong. I think on balance, if I would get one, I'd get the Trumpeter Type 45. Really thoroughly enjoying it. And as I say, I'm hoping to not necessarily go to town on it because I don't know enough, but throw in, you know, put in a few more boxes. I've bought some more decals. I'm prepared even, I'm going to see if I can mock up some of my own decals to go on, because these things are plastered in, do not put your head down this gun barrel and keep your hands away from the helicopter propellers and all this type of stuff, you know what I mean? It's plastered in them. The modern age now of, you know, just warnings for everything. So guys, thanks a lot. I'm waffling, I know, it's what I do. Next time you see her, I've no idea how far she'll be forward. You know, as again, I'm picking her up, you know, doing half hour here, an hour there. I've, you know, obviously got a lot of painting to do, so figure painting to do. So I do that. Give you an update, verbal one anyway, on the FT-17. That's been having some chipping done to it over the last few days. Put a filter over her, but I've only got one side chipped so far. So that's probably going to be a week away before I show you the next instalment of that one. We've still got no further forward on the snow speeder. It just needs to get completed. But with my head, you know what it's like this, doing this ship, I'll veer off on a tangent, then come back to the snow speeder, and it'll be voila, it's done, you know. So, yeah, and obviously we've got some figure painting videos. But modelling-wise, we've got that done. The Starfighter needs to get completed as well. I've said to myself, I've got another model that I'm going to be building soon, 1:35 scale wise. So I want the FT-17 done, I want Kent done, I want the Snowspeeder done, and I want the Starfighter done before I do anything else, because otherwise I'm just going to get a right mess, which I'm verging on at the moment. So please do follow along with if you're interested in ships, and if you're not, you know, you might still find some of his interest as Gav breaks one thing after another on these very delicate little parts. So look after yourselves, and we'll catch each other very soon on another video.